Today's topic is called What Does the Bible Say About Pastors Eating Your Money? Are they not supposed to eat your money? Okay, I'm sure you hear this every day. People complaining about pastors eating their money, buying expensive cars, building mansions, big houses, you know, and all those things. And people be like, in churches, all they want is money. But now to look at it, especially looking at the scriptures, don't they have the right to eat your money? I think some of you, or in fact, I'm pretty sure that some of you might already think that no ways, they're not supposed to eat our money. Okay, but then I have a scripture reference, like, maybe you can look at, okay, for example, let's start before we go to the main scripture that I want us to check. When you look at Jesus, when there were people giving in the church, he was observing, and the one who gave, there was this lady, she was this woman who was very poor, and she gave from the last money that she had. And Jesus commended her for that because she gave from the least that she had, from the last money that she had. But the rest, it was like they gave out of their riches. So he honored her giving more. And if you can look at the book of Malachi chapter 3, it also speaks of tithings and offerings, that you are robbing God when you're not paying those and you're not giving. Which shows that giving is a necessity in the house of God. We cannot never run away from that. So there is no excuse for not giving. Okay, someone now has a question. What about those who are taking advantage of the people eating, they are ministering for the sake of eating money from the people? Yes, you can go to 1 Corinthians chapter 9 from verse 11 up to 15. Most preferably, in fact, yeah, it's verse 11 up to 15. But you can start from verse 1 if you want to understand everything. Paul was also talking about that since he's been planting spiritual food, is he not supposed to reap material things from the church or from them? In fact, in those verses, Paul was speaking, trying to emphasize that he has the right to reap from them. In fact, as a minister, he also emphasized that in those verses, that is, under normal circumstances, as a minister, you're supposed to reap where you work. In fact, in general, every person. So he referred that even as for them, they were supposed as ministers to reap from the people. They're supposed to eat from the people. And he was like, but he has never used that privilege on them. For Paul, at the end, he said it just because it will deny him from boasting, since he had never asked any money from them. But at the end of the day, he said that he had every right to get money from them. So at the end of the day, the church must take care of their pastor. There's no excuse. A pastor must get money from you as a church. Yes, someone might ask or wonder, okay, does it mean that they have I'm not condoning those who are taking advantage of people. Now they are ministering for the sake of getting rich, getting money. No. I'm referring to situations where someone is ministering the word of God in truth, and I'm not condoning those pastors who are just taking advantage. No. At the end of the day, it's not a matter of a pastor taking advantage. They're not supposed to take advantage. They're not supposed to minister for the sake of people giving. And it's for them to get rich and while they are sucking money out of the people. No. But at the end of the day, if the church is paying the pastor and he manages to save up this money and he buys an expensive car, build a big house, are we supposed to criticize, be against that? No, he saved that. That was the money which was due to him. But then, yes, a pastor as well In fact, in case pastors are also watching, isn't also not supposed to minister now to ask money, make services, make crusades and conferences for the sake of taking money from the people or gaining money at the end of the day. You found out you did something so that people can give offerings, not because God directed you or you were following the leading of the Holy Spirit. So at the end of the day, you do all those things out of the leading of the Holy Spirit. And the people will have to give you the money that they can afford. That is enough, that is due to you. So even to people at the end of the day with this video, I just wanted you to understand that at the end of the day, the church, you people, you must take care of your pastors, your ministers, or whoever is delivering the message of God. And also the minister, don't start to take advantage, don't try to do this just to gain, for your own personal gain, to get rich, you know, all those things. Any further questions, be free to comment. Further elaborations, free to comment, feel free. If you like today's video, give it a thumbs up, share, and remember to subscribe and follow me in my Instagram. As for me, Ishmael, and I will see you next time.